What the fuck?
I wanna see your cheeks glow red.
Cancels every day, night, stays home, never leaves. Just can't find the energy. I stay pretty numb, never felt for anyone. You seem similar.
Long as we got hopping on the best, I would not you like them, then. But you did that. Why you so damn good to me? I'm telling all my friends how you put it down, losing all my.
Tutorial para hacer pulpito amigurumi, parte 1. Para las cabecitas, anillo mágico de 8 puntos bajos y aumentamos hasta tener 64 puntos y trabajamos en espiral. En la vuelta 21 y 22 ya reduzco y me quedan 56 puntos bajos. Hay que hacerlo dos veces, claro. En dos colores diferentes para las dos cabecitas. Las patitas, anillo mágico de 4 puntos de cada color. Aumento hasta la vuelta 3, de la vuelta 4 a la 6 me quedan 24 puntos, en la 7 ya reduzco y de la vuelta 8 a la 12 me quedan 16 puntos, 8 de cada color. En total tienes que tener las dos cabecitas, las 8 patitas y los ojitos que los puedes comprar o los puedes hacer. Los míos son anillos mágicos de 6 puntos, 12 y 12, la segunda y la tercera vuelta de 12 puntos bajos. Y ahora viene lo guay, les pones las caritas, les haces la boquita y ahora vamos a montarlo. Importante, la cabecita que está dentro tiene que estar al revés. Y sigue con la parte 2, que ahora viene lo bonito. Parte 2 del pulpito reversible. Amigurumi decía que la cabecita de dentro tiene que estar al revés para que cuando las gires te queden así. Rellena las cabecitas y las patitas, cóselas todas por los dos lados y acuérdate de esconder todos los hilos. Y tara, este es tu pulpito amigurumi reversible. Puedes escoger los colores que más te gusten y si te gusta cómo los hago yo, entra en mi tienda MeriPlanet en Etsy.com y déjame un corazoncito si te han gustado los tutoriales. ¡Muchas gracias!
Today I'm going to show you how to make a magic circle. So first you're going to take the loose end of your yarn and wrap it twice around your middle and ring finger, and then hold the loose ends between your thumb and pinky. Then you're going to take your crochet hook and go under the loop, grab the working yarn, and pull it through. Now you'll have one loop on your hook. You're going to yarn over again and pull that through so you again have one loop on your hook and have formed a slip stitch. Next, we're gonna make 6 single crochets into the loop. So you're gonna go under, grab the yarn, now you'll have 2 loops on your hook. You're gonna yarn over and pull that through both the loops, so now you only have 1 loop on your hook. You're gonna repeat this 6 times. To close the loop, you're gonna pull on one of these strings until the loop closes. Might take a little bit of wiggling. Then you're gonna take the loose end and pull it to close the rest of the loop. Here's your magic circle.
Today I'll be showing you the essential crochet tools you need for each project. First, you will need your hooks. The size of your hook depends on the weight of your yarn and how tight you want your stitches. Next, of course, is your yarn. There's lots of yarn weights out there and the one that you choose depends on your project. Next, you have your stitch markers. I like to use safety pins and these help you remember key stitch placements. Additional materials would be a tapestry needle, measuring tape, and of course scissors. Happy crocheting!
Babbo Natale!
Che c'è?
Non dimenticare il Grinch. Lo so che è cattivo, puzzolente e peloso. Forse le sue mani sono fredde e scivolose. Ma secondo me lui è dolce.
Dolce?
Mm-hmm.
Like you cut, G.
Now that I got a taste, I think that I'd suffocate for every second that you are by my side. But now I'm stuck at the gate, a Lucifer's estate. I fell in love with a girl I met in hell, thinking about
Cozy Crochet Beanie Tutorial.
Step 1. Make some rectangles, as many as you want. Step 2. Weave the yarn through the long side of your rectangle. Don't be afraid to really, really manhandle it. It's fine. It won't break. Step 3. Scrunch it up. Scrunch it. Scrunch it right up. Scrunch it all. Scrunch the hat. Step 4. Whip stitch the edges together. This is when it's going to start looking more like a hat and less like a rectangle. Step 5. Tie off the yarn, weave in the ends, and then do a snippy snip. Step 6. Turn it inside out, flip the brim, and now it'll really look like a beanie. Oh, look at them. They really look like beanies. They don't look like rectangles anymore. Yeah, you made a beanie.
Look at you, strawberry blonde, fields rolling on. I love it when you call my name. Can you hear the bumblebee swarm watching your arm? I love it when you look my way. Look at you, strawberry blonde, fields rolling on. I love it when you call my name. Can you hear the bumblebee swarm watching your arm? You strawberry blonde, fields rolling on. I love it when you call my name. Can you hear the bumblebee swarm watching your arm? I love it when you look my way. Look at you, strawberry blonde, fields rolling on. I love it when you call my name. Can you hear the bumblebee swarm?
Hey y'all, y'all wanted me to show you how to make a bucket hat, so I'm about to show you. So first thing you want to do is chain 4. And then you're going to insert your hook into that first chain so you can make a little circle without having to make a magic circle, because I don't know how to do that. So after you do that, you're going to make a slip knot and then go ahead and chain 2. And you're going to put 10 half double crochets in your round, but I'm about to show y'all where to actually put the half double crochets because I don't want you to mess up. So you're going to put it in the middle hole, and it's going to be like not hard to put your crochet hook in. So when you've done your 10 half double crochets, you're just going to slip stitch into that first half double crochet, and then you're going to tighten so that you don't see a hole anymore. And then you're going to chain 2 and insert 2 half double crochets in each of the stitches that you just made. And then you're going to slip stitch into that last one and chain 2. Okay, this is part 2 of the crochet bucket hat tutorial. Pay attention to the next few rows. So in your last row, you increased every stitch, and this row, you're going to increase every second stitch. So you're going to do 1 half double crochet in the first stitch and 2 half double crochets in the next stitch, and then 1, and then 2, and so on. Same as every row, you slip stitch into that first half double crochet, chain 2, and keep going. Next row, you increase every third stitch. So in the first 2 stitches, you're going to put 1 half double crochet, and then in the third stitch, you're going to put 2 half double crochets. I hope you guys can see the pattern I'm trying to hint at here. The next row, you want to increase every 4th stitch, and the row after that, you want to increase every 5th stitch, and so on and so forth, until it's the width that you want for your head. When I make hats for myself, I usually do 8 or 9 rows. I'm doing this for my little sister, so I'm going to make about 6 rows. I ended up doing 7 rows. So that's the very top of the hat. Okay, I explained that best as I could in 60 seconds. I'm sorry if it was confusing. Like for part 3! Okay, I'm gonna show you how to finish this bucket hat. So for the next few rows, you're gonna stop doing increased stitches. You're just going to put 1 half double crochet in each stitch. This is gonna make that part that goes like around your head. And because you're not increasing the stitches, it's not gonna go out anymore. It's just gonna go like down. So you can see it kind of flipping up there. So I ended up doing 8 rows of no increase, and that's how it looked. And now it's time to work on the brim. So the first row of the brim is no increase, but you're going to be working in the front loops only. So I hope you guys can see that. It's front loops only. And that's going to make it like go outwards. And then super important, you're going to look at the last time you did an increase row and see how many of those that you did. So if your last increase on the 7th stitch, this time you're going to do your increase on the 8th stitch and then keep doing increasing around the entire brim. Once you've reached your desired brim length, you just cut and fasten off and you are done with your bucket hat. Thanks for watching. Tell me what other tutorials you guys want me to do.